How are you doing, guys? It's Big Mac Dan School here again. And I've just got a quick video for you today and an appeal. So this is the first day of what I'm calling my temporary retirement. Basically, I've been made redundant from my current job. Went in for my final consultation meeting today to discuss severance package and stuff like that. And if they could find me another job somewhere else in the company, basically. Discussing the severance package, it's going to leave me with money to sustain me till I find my next job, money to train up for my next job, but also a little bit of money, hopefully, that I can spend on myself, you know, on my hobby, basically. So one thing I've been looking at getting is an airbrush. So after doing a little bit of research, what I want is, I think I'm going to go for a basic airbrush and a mid-level compressor. I was looking at the entry-level airbrush bundle on Element Games website, and the compressor on that, it recommends you don't run it for any more than 10 minutes, and then you have to cool it down. So I don't really want to have to stop every 10 minutes. It'd be quite annoying, I think. So like I said, I'm going for a mid-level compressor. The compressor I'm going to probably be getting, depending on what advice you guys can give me, is the Iwata Ninja Jet compressor. So that recommends cooling it down after every 30 minutes or so. Now, it doesn't, according to the technical specifications, it doesn't have a moisture filter. So that's one thing to bear in mind. But other than that, it looks like a really good compressor. The ones with the moisture filters, you're looking at almost double the price. But you know, you get what you pay for, basically. So, but because it's my first I can always upgrade a compressor. I can always get a new compressor. And same goes for the airbrush, because the airbrush I'm starting out with is the Neo Furiwata CN Gravity Feed Airbrush, which is the cheapest one on the Element Games site. But it's got good reviews. Now it's Element Games themselves that have reviewed it. But it looks like a decent airbrush. If you guys can give me any advice on this, whether, you know, I'm going in with the airbrush, I'm going in at the bottom end of the spectrum, and with the compressor, I think it's a mid-level compressor. So if you think that's the right thing for me to do, that'd be great if you could let me know. If you've got any advice, maybe I should go for a different compressor, a different airbrush, I don't know. Let me know what you guys think, anyone that's experienced in compressors and airbrushes. I'd really appreciate it, as it's a lot of money to be spending, but I don't mind spending a little bit more as long as I get a lot more, if you know what I mean. The main thing I was looking at for the compressor was the recommended running time. And I know there's things like if it doesn't have a reservoir, there's a pulsing effect sometimes. I've looked into it a little bit, but you know, it's a lot of money to be spending, like I said. So any advice you can give me would be greatly appreciated. Pop it in the comments below if you could, or if you can direct me to any buying guides or anything like that, that'd be really helpful as well. What I'll do as well, in the description below, I'll put a link to Element Games website, and I'll put a link to the airbrush I'm buying, and one to the compressor I'm buying as well. If you can give me any advice, it'd be really appreciated. Thanks very much for watching. Like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you on the battlefield.